My 5-year-old daughter has a curiosity for learning about the cosmos or the space objects. I don't know from where she got this idea of space and objects or things like that. She once asked me, "Dad, can you tell me more about the space and cosmos because you are so much into it?" I said, "Sure." So here it goes. Once upon a time, I was in Mauna Kea Observatory in Big Island, Hawaii. I was looking at the stars, gazing at the shining stars in the Milky Way, and all of a sudden, I fell asleep. Maybe the beautiful sight of the stars made me doze off into a slumber. I woke up. What did I see? I saw a deserted, barren land, like a deserted battlefield all around me. I was thinking, what is this place? This time, I don't see anything. Far away, I was seeing a beautiful blue planet. What a planet! That looks so good! Ah, sir, you're looking at my creator, the Earth. Creator Earth? What? Who's that? Oh, maybe. Are you Mr. Moon? Are you talking to me? The moon replied, yes. Mr. Moon, I see some tracks over here as if they were done yesterday. Oh, they are of the first person who walked on me. Oh, maybe it's Neil Armstrong. Mr. Moon, why do I feel light over here? That's because you have on my gravity, which is very low. I felt really happy. Wow, I'm on moon without doing anything. Then, far away, I saw an orange spot. A bright orange spot, and I immediately recognized that's Venus. I asked Moon, isn't it that the morning star, Venus, the goddess of love? The moon laughed, haha, find it out yourself. And the moment the moon said that, a spaceship came in front of me. I boarded the spaceship and went towards Venus. I was feeling, wow, what a beautiful planet Venus is. But as I neared the planet, I felt suffocated. It was so hot, it was so obnoxious that I felt, what's this? Venus warmly greeted me. Welcome to the land of volcanoes. Volcanoes? There were eruptions all over the place. There were so many eruptions on the planet, it would dwarf the ones we see on Earth. I told Venus, thank you, ma'am. But isn't this like global warming gone wild? Venus replied, yes, it is. But I wish my sister Earth could not face the same fate in future. Then I thought, maybe I need to visit something more. I saw the sun at another place. It was big. It felt like I was looking at a Medusa. Just like if you see a Medusa, it's so bright, you can't want to look at it, or you don't want to look at it, but you can't resist it. I set my sail through my spaceship towards the sun. As I was going through the sun, I saw Mercury, the planet Mercury, which had conflicting temperatures on its two ends. At one end, it was very cold, almost -270°C, according to Wikipedia. And on the other side, it was really, really, really hot, 800°C. I don't want to be on the planet and get myself unnecessary cold. I don't know what kind of cold will I get. Then I was at the sun. It was 10,000°C, very hot. There was a turbulent sea of gases. And I heard a strong voice. Hey, who goes there? Don't come near my surface. Otherwise, my magnetic flares would fry you up. Yes, the magnetic fields, the loops of the magnetic field of the sun were so big that we could fit a dozen Earths in it. It was so huge. I said, Mr. Sun, how strong are these fields? The sun replied, ha. What do you know about these fields? They are so strong that Even the volcanoes of the entire solar system are dwarfs in front of the strength of these flares. Ooh, I need to run out. So I thought I need to go to some edge of the galaxy, maybe the edge of the solar system for now, and press a one button onto the on the spaceship. So have you seen, you might know there's something like a one button in Star Trek movies. So I pressed that button and I was off to Sedna. What is Sedna? Sedna is a planetoid 8 million miles away from Earth. It's on the edge of the galaxy. As I approached Sedna, Sedna spoke to me. Hey, Mr. Alien, where are you off to? Me, an alien? I said, hi Sedna, I'm off on a cosmic adventure, like a little hobbit. Oh, you are similar to the object that went past me a few years back with all kind of weird voices. I thought, was it the Voyager 1? The farthest cosmic object into the space from Earth? Yeah, it had all the voices from the Earth, welcome voices. To which Sedna replied, is it wise to shout in the middle of a jungle? Stephen Hawking's voice hit my mind. Then I thought, okay, let me go ahead. And I reached Alpha Centauri. Actually, I hit a hyperspace button and went like a Star Wars, went to a galaxy far, far away. And Alpha Centauri was in front of me, which was 4 light years away from Earth. I didn't find anything interesting, so I moved on. And I was seeing the supermassive volcanoes, or the supernova explosions, and I saw magnetars, all kind of cool things. Finally, I reached UY Scuti, which is the biggest red giant ever known to our stuff. The UY Scuti was so big, like you could fit 1,700 sun into it, and it was 34,000 brighter than sun. I thought, wow, this is so huge. And I was, all of a sudden, I was getting sucked into a warp. That warp felt like a black hole, a super massive black hole. I got frightened. Oh, what's happening? If I get into the event horizon, I will be sucked in, and there is no point of return because of the infinite density and the gravity and whatnot. And to my hope, a flash of light pushed me up. It said, go away, I'm helping you, because I'm helping myself get out of this black hole. It was so bright that it was like 4 trillion times brighter than the sun. I recognized, this is a geyser. Thank God it's to my rescue. But it was so strong that poof, I disappeared with the light of geyser. I was back on the Earth and had a relief. And my daughter asked me, Dad, tell me more stories about this. Thank you.